Welcome back to Cheddar, everyone. We also want to welcome those of you listening to Cheddar on iHeartRadio.
We have your ears.
All right, guys. South Dakota and a number of other states are trying to get online retailers like Wayfair to pay state sales taxes, even if that company doesn't have a physical store in that state. The debate has made its way to the Supreme Court, and a decision should be made today. With us now is Melissa Armo, owner at the stock Swoosh. Melissa, thanks for joining us today. Can you put this into context for us? How big of a deal is this for internet companies like Wayfair?
I think this is a big deal. In fact, I think the outcome of the decision today is a big deal, not just for Wayfair, but for Overstock.com, Amazon, other companies that sell a lot of things online. This is a big decision today. Actually, nobody really knows what the outcome is going to be because they thought it was going to side originally more in favor of South Dakota, and now nobody knows. But one thing's for sure, if they end up deciding in the favor of the states where they will allow pretty much anything to be charged that the states decide in their favor for the taxes, then a lot more states are going to start to charge. And you could see a reaction today, a negative reaction in the stocks that I just mentioned. Whereas right now, Wayfair looks great. Amazon looks great. I mean, some of these stocks have been looking great for quite a long time now, and they could have a negative reaction day. Of course, they could have a positive reaction if it turns out to be in their favor. Just we don't know.
What's a good outcome for consumers here?
That's the problem for consumers. Obviously, we don't want to pay any more taxes. So, you know, as a person that shops online, I'm sure you both shop online too. Why? It's nice to be able to order something and not have to pay the tax. Whereas if I would go into a local store here in Manhattan, I would pay a tax. So this is to benefit the states. It's not to benefit the consumer if they do pass this tax and allow it. And it's definitely not to benefit the corporations, because then what's going to happen is these big corporations are competing. One of the reasons they've done so well is they're competing head to head with brick-and-mortar stores, brick-and-mortar retail stores that do have a physical presence in the states and are forced by state law required to charge the requisite tax. And so it depends where you are in the spectrum. If you're like a Best Buy and you've got a physical presence in a state, or if you're like an Amazon and you don't, it depends what kind of corporation you are. But these stocks have really seen the benefit of sales because they don't have to charge taxes, which makes it cheaper for the consumer. There's no good outcome here for the consumer if it passes and if all the states are allowed to charge taxes for online goods and purchases.
Melissa, if South Dakota, if that side of the debate wins here, aside from regular consumers, who stands to lose the most here? Will smaller retailers be able to sort of keep up with calculating these taxes and imposing these taxes on their users?
Do you mean if they side in the favor of the Wayfair, or you lost me there, or if South Dakota wins?
That's interesting. Exactly.
Yeah. Are you saying that small businesses could benefit? Not necessarily, because you know you're still going to price shop some certain items that you want. You're going to go get the best price. And when you're competing against some of these stores like Wayfair that has really competitive prices, Overstock.com, very competitive, Amazon competitive, it's still hard for any mom and pop store, any small business to compete with these stores. I mean, they'll find another way then. They'll find another way. But as far as the consumer, you're still, I think, going to save more if you have to pay less taxes, but you know, no matter what, how you look at it. I don't think that the small mom and pops can compete against these big retailers. And this is the environment that we're going in. We're going in an environment where there's less mom and pops, less small businesses, and more of these giant, gymungous places that sell stuff that are just becoming bigger and bigger and bigger.
Right. So, I mean, what I mean is, could this be even worse for those small retailers who can't afford to have to charge higher taxes to their customers than say, an Amazon?
Yes, definitely. They're definitely going to be worse for those. Yes.
Okay, so I guess my question would be, Melissa, there's already over 30 states already tax internet purchases, so how big of a deal is this Supreme Court decision anyway?
Well, I don't really know exactly who taxes what, but if I might be...
I think that's part of the problem, though.
Yeah, I think it varies. There are 31 states, but they all have different tax rates. In other words, if I want to buy something online right now, I'm pretty certain with Amazon, I don't pay almost 9%, which is New York sales tax rate. So whatever the tax rate is, it's a less tax rate than it is if I walk into a store and buy a pair of shoes. So that's why this is so specific. And it eventually, depending on the outcome today, it eventually makes to have to go to Congress, and then Congress may have to vote on this because this is becoming a bigger and a bigger deal.
All right, Melissa, we'll have to leave it there. Thank you so much, as always. Melissa Armo, owner at the stock Swoosh. Thanks for joining us here today.
Thanks.
All right, guys, it is time to say goodbye, but don't go anywhere. Between Bells is starting next. See you guys later.